when they have the opportunity, if they can return back to their home school, they are so far behind, and most of them were already behind before they went to these schools. And then court involvement in juvenile detention centers. We have several of our children that have deputy juvenile officers. So as a child, you have a DJO, and you become an adult, and you get a PO. So be funny. So they move from a DJO to a PO, and I don't think we really thought about that. What child wants a DJO? Because we're already criminalizing them. We're already putting them in the mindset, so we're prepping them. We're preparing them. And this is perpetuated, and sometimes we don't even realize. Sometimes in our classrooms, we are doing things ourselves, and we don't even know we're doing it. The first line of defense starts with you. In the classroom. And you might say, oh, Dr. Smith, but it's so hard. No, it's not. Well, why are you saying it's not hard? It's not hard because you signed up to do this. You knew that this is what you wanted to do. So if you knew this is what you wanted to do, then you already knew the consequences and the rewards that come with the territory. So it's time for us to stop lying and stop crying and put our big girl pants on and our big boy pants on and do what's in the best interest of these children. Because this right here, it's not working. It's ineffective. It's really sad. It's ugly. So what we're going to look at so that we can actually see the face of this thing and how we have children being placed into this school-to-prison pipeline, and it is just so ridiculous, we can't even begin to understand it. We're going to put a picture with the face so that we can see how this looks. And we're going to take a look at a student by the name of Kai.
You ready?
Okay. My name is Kyle Thompson. I like playing football, playing video games, hanging out with my friends.
The vice principal said if I had a school full of kids like yours, I'd be the happiest man in the district.
Kyle's a very sensitive kid. I mean, he's fun to coach, he's fun to be around.
For somebody with his personality to get in this kind of trouble is so shocking to me. I didn't see it coming. I could never have imagined this.
Just on face value.
I had a list in my bag of it was titled hit list, but it wasn't really to hurt anybody. And my friend took it out of my notebook. I saw him take it out, so I took it back from him. And my teacher came over, she took it from me. And I got up and I grabbed the paper and we were pulling it back and forth.
All of what the statement said, the teacher was laughing, the teacher was playing, we were all laughing, we were all playing.
When we were pulling back and forth, she was laughing at first, so I thought it was just as a joke, but she got serious and I let go. And she left the class, and then the hall monitor came, and they escorted me to the office. The principal told the police officer to take me to the police station. And the scariest part was probably being handcuffed to inside of there. I felt that I deserved maybe a couple days of suspension at most, but I didn't think it was really 180 days worth of a consequence.
When there's activities up at the school he can't attend, he can't go watch his sister, he can't watch his former teammates play.
I can't play football, so really I just throw football around with my friends, play video games, watch TV, but I don't really see my friends as much.
Here I am now, thousands of dollars later, 6-7 months down the road, and all day long when I'm gone, I worry about Kyle. My son has